everybody, Nikki D from Five Dog Farm on what is a great work day. We've had a storm blow through. I hate to say it out loud. The sun is behind the clouds. You know what happens when I say that. And Mr. Blue James and I thought we would get to a task that we've been wanting to do. We have a lot of gates in the sheep donkey area. And we want to start bringing the dogs out to train them for taking care of the sheep. However, they're just the right size to get through each and every gate. And we don't want them breaching the donkey area until, well, we just don't want them breaching the donkey area ever, I don't think. So we were wondering, what do we do? And we kind of came up with this little homestead hack. We've got our red top fencing here. And what we thought we'd do is measure each gate, cut the fencing to the size we need, and attach it to the gate. Now, you can buy these gates with this type of attachment on it already. They're not cheap. And honestly, I've seen them brand new in a supply yard where the fencing weld has already popped off. So, to make our gates a little more versatile, we're just going to attach this, and down the road, if we don't need it anymore, because we've used what is our favorite homestead hack item? Zip ties and duct tape. And that's how we're attaching these. So we're gonna go ahead and get to it. We've got about 7 gates to take care of in the sheep donkey area. And that way we can rest assured that the dogs are not gonna escape and take off to, well, where the birds are, because they don't really love the birds except as an appetizer. So we can't let them roam. We need a different type of dog for that. So Miss Blue Jeans and I are just gonna get to it, and we'll show you the end result when we're done. Versatile and roll with the punches. When we had bought these gates, we got them for a great price, but we didn't think about having a dog or an animal inside that could get through it. And let's just say within 5 minutes a dog showed us that they could get through it, and then that made us think, well, what else could get through it that we don't want to have come through? We do have a coyote problem. So this solves that, but it still gives us the other type of a gate that if we needed to use it for something else, we could remove the fencing. So we kind of like to do it like that. We're not long-range planners in the respect that, yes, we know we need to build a sheep barn, yes, we're building the chicken coop, but I guess I shouldn't say long-range. Day-to-day, we have an idea of what we want to get done. We know what we want to do, and for any of you who are living on a homestead right now, you know that's a wonderful thing until something else happens. And you run over there with your bucket to put out that fire, and then the thing you planned really didn't happen. So I'd say we're loose daily planners with a nice futuristic outlook on what we'd like to have done in time. So anyway, this is just one of those little hacks that that we thought we would share with you because we like the versatility of it, and it certainly is something that you can do too. So thanks for joining me. This is Nikki D from Five Dog Farm. We'll talk to you soon.